Yeah, Mike, that's right. And if you were along the marathon route very early Sunday morning, no doubt you noticed car after car being towed. And then we noticed a lot of people posting about this, being upset about this on social media. So we set out to find out how many cars were towed, no doubt generating thousands and thousands of dollars. Adelaide Raymond found out the hard way. The city and its hired tow trucks were almost as determined as those marathon runners.
I came out probably like 12:05, 12:10, and my car was gone.
Only a few minutes past midnight Saturday, she says her car, parked near the Pitt campus on Forbes Avenue, was gone, and so were all the others.
There was no car on the street. I don't know how they would have gotten them all gone that early. They must have started either right on the dot or right before.
Mayor Bill Peduto had tweeted this warning, quote, "If you parked anywhere along the marathon route, your car is being towed right now." The tickets, $134 each, plus...
There was also the parking ticket, which was $100.
At $234 a pop, we wondered how many cars were towed this weekend. We took a drive through the marathon route and, of course, passed hundreds of cars typically parked on a 26-mile stretch. But when we spoke with Bob McGann, the owner of McGann and Chester Towing, he says while there were about 180 cars towed prior to the marathon last year, he believes the count this year will prove to be dozens fewer. In 2013, he says some people tore down the posted warning signs. But in 2014, the city says police focused on double-checking that all signs were still up on May 4th. But once again, drivers found out that the city and the tow truck facility was leaving no leeway once the clocks hit midnight.
It was a really small room, so everyone was kind of crowded in, and it was just everyone was really angry. Everyone had the same reaction to it.
So that driver and other people we talked to were upset, but they say they know that really in the end it was their mistake, so they say that they have learned their lesson, they say, for next year. Point Live, I'm Andrew Del Greco, Pittsburgh's Action News 4.